Hallo, hallo. So, jetzt haben wir noch eine kleine Aktion. Und bevor wir die starten, würde ich ganz gerne was dazu sagen. Der Staat kriminalisiert uns, bestraft uns, was für ganz viele Menschen super weitreichende Folgen hat. Daher fordern wir die Abschaffung des BTMG, wie es heute ist, und fordern stattdessen eine Legalisierung aller Substanzen.
Ja.
Symbolisch dafür wird heute der Paragraph hier verschwinden. Bestenfalls.
The roof is on fire. The roof is on fire. We don't need no water. Let the mother burn. Burn, mother. And I'm a dumb white guy. I'm not old or new, but middle school, fifth grade, like junior high. I don't know mofo, y'all peeps be fucking giving props to my bushy fly. But I can take the heat, cause I'm the other white meat known as Kid Funky Fry. Yeah, I'm hung like planet Pluto, hard to see with a naked eye. But if I crashed into Uranus, I would stick it where the sun don't shine. Cause I'm kind of like Han Solo, stroking my own wolfie. I'm the root of all that's evil. Yeah, but you can call me Cookie. The roof is on fire. The roof is on fire. The roof is on fire. We don't need no water. Let the mother burn. Burn, mother. This hardcore ghetto gangster image takes a lot of practice. I'm not black like Barry White, no, I am white like Frank Black is. So if man is 5 and the devil is 6, then that must make me 7. This hockey's gone to heaven, but if I go to hell, well then I hope I burn well. I'll spend my days with JFK, Marvin Gaye, Mother Ray, and Lawrence Welk. The roof, the roof, the roof is on fire. The roof, the roof, the roof.
infinite little paradise because the irony, the strong, the tyrant, they will enter inside of me. So paradise is being a bit insecure, you could say. Why are the weak ones gonna go inside me? Jahannam, because the strong people, why, Ya Rab? And Allah said, the Jannah, paradise, you are my mercy. With you I reward the weak and the humble. Who goes into paradise? The weak and the humble. And then Allah said to the hellfire, you're my punishment. With you I will punish the arrogant ones. And then Allah said, each and every single one of you will have your full. Jannah, I will fill you. Hellfire, I will fill you. You know what's scary? Before we come back to the hadith, there's an ayah in the Quran. Allah said, يَوْمَ نَقُولُ لِجَهَنَّمَ. On the day, Allah said, when we will speak to Jahannam. Allah talk, remember, the hellfire. Hellfire is not a place. That's like a little dungeon, you know that, right? That's all this pagan Christian stuff where they think hellfire is a little place beneath the earth, you know, where the devil is the king of the hell. No. Hellfire is a beast. Hellfire speaks. Hellfire rules. Hellfire breathes in. Hellfire breathes out. Hellfire attacks. Why hellfire is an animal. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, when the hellfire is being brought down on that day, when that day, 70,000 angels, because hellfire will be out of control. Hellfire will want to destroy the enemies of Allah. Hellfire will want to destroy the sinners, the innovators, the disbelievers. Hellfire will want to swallow them, roast them, toast them, break them, shake them, twist them. Hellfire will want to annihilate them, because hellfire is afraid of Allah. Allah is angry. Allah is angry on a day like he's never been angry before. And the hellfire will be brought. The hellfire will be uncontrollable. The hellfire will be untamable. So much so that there will be 70,000 ropes. Like when you have a dog, you have a leash, right? Hold the dog. There's going to be 70,000 leashes on hellfire. And each leash will have 70,000 angels. Hellfire will say, Hal min mazid. Allah, give me more. I'm hungry, Ya Rab, give me more. I'm not full yet. Allah, give me more. 70,000 angels. Because hellfire will be out of control. Hellfire will want to destroy the enemies of Allah. Hellfire will want to destroy the sinners, the innovators, the disbelievers. Hellfire will want to swallow them, roast them, toast them, break them, shake them, quake them. Hellfire will want to annihilate them. Because hellfire is a slave of Allah. How dare you disrespect Allah? How dare you disobey? So on that day, when you're there standing in front of hellfire, the way it will swallow, the way it will take you, the way it will absorb you, brothers, that's not a day to play with. That's not a beast you want to play with. The angels, 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 7, 10, 100 angels themselves are struggling to hold it down. 70,000 ropes, 70,000 angels on each rope. Anyone who can do the math? 4.9 billion angels are holding it down. 4.9. How big is an angel? Jibreel has got 600 wings. Jibreel has 600 wings. How big is an angel? Jibreel has 600 wings. On the tip of one of his wings, he lifted up the people of Lut, people of Sodom and Gomorrah. Them man. He picked them up from the tip of his wing. That's how big an angel is. I'm saying, oh, that's Jibreel, of course he's the grandest of them all. But I'm saying, so you get a gist. Angels are not weak, and there's 4.9 billion of them. 70,000 angels! Because hellfire will be out of control! Hellfire will want to destroy the enemies of Allah! Hellfire will want to destroy the sinners, the innovators, the disbelievers! Hellfire will want to swallow them, roast them, toast them, break them, shake them, twist them! Hellfire will want to annihilate them! So coming back to the ayah, then we come back to the hadith. Allah said, يَوْمَ نَقُولُ لِجَهَنَّمُ. On the day we'll speak to this hellfire, this beast, we'll speak to it. What Allah said, had him collapse. Are you full? Are you satisfied? Have you settled your hunger, O Jahannam? Have you eaten enough of them? Have you burnt enough of them?
Those people that walk on the streets with their trousers sagging low, who walk into a room with their head up high, thinking that they're something, when in reality, they're nothing.